Thank you so much for joining us, Mr. Niranjan Hiranandani, sir. How are you?
I'm good. I'm happy to be with you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. And
thank you, Akash.
Yes. So, sir, I know you have something for all our students and you are going to address us. The whole screen is yours. The virtual stage is yours. So please carry on. Then I'll continue my questions later on.
Wonderful. Thank you, Akash. Thank you very much. It's a pleasure and privilege to be with all the young people over here. They gladden my heart. So for me, it's always a pleasure to speak to the young people. The young people actually give me josh.
Yes.
And actually make me feel stronger and better. I'm only 70 years by age, but I feel as young as you are. So it's such a pleasure really to be here with you all today. And I take a great delight about it. I sincerely believe that a better time is there in the future than it has been in the past. So you are the real lucky ones. You know, in my good old days when I was young, there were very few types of career paths that we could take. Today, the number of career paths that you can take are huge. It's unbelievable. So each of the items of subjects that you take, whether you take science or you take arts or you take commerce, even in commerce, you have so many things which you can do. You can do insurance, you can do BAF, you can do BBM, you can do so many things which is there. And on art side now also, you have a lot of variety. And in the science side, of course, you have a lot of variety. Engineering, you have another variety of items and so many things to do. Look at the kind of media business that is there. Advertising, publicity, going digital, like we are doing today. All these things have come up in the last couple of years. So the opportunity of the future is great. So young friends, don't worry about anything of the future, but make the best of the present. And what do I mean by making the best of the present? It is to be able to absorb as much as you can get, suck in like a sponge, all the knowledge and gyan that you have. Pick up and sponge all the new ideas that are there. Go to the internet, find out more about every type of business, every type of careers, every type of other thing. And honestly, I'll tell you, there is so much to do and so many exciting things that there is no tomorrow. But so that's my first suggestion. Try to see all the other options that are available to you and keep learning. The number two thing, which I think is extremely important for young people, there are small skill sets which become important in life, like studying how to concentrate. This is something which most of the young people have forgotten. They get distracted too easily. I too was like that. So it was so easy to get distracted for me. Television, internet, all the other thing, Instagram, WhatsApp, all this is a huge distraction. So really to concentrate on anything in life is really becoming very difficult for the young people. So one of the things which I suggest very strongly is to pick up how to concentrate and pick up a few ideas and thoughts to do. It's not difficult, but once you start doing it, it becomes a habit. Pick up anything that you like to do. It doesn't matter what it is. You like to read a particular subject, pick up and concentrate on reading. See to it that while you are doing at least 20 pages, you will not touch the WhatsApp, switch it off, switch off the Wi-Fi for that time. Don't do anything which will actually distract you and focus on it. Picking up anything in terms of it. So the learning to concentrate and not get distracted is a very, very important character that you have to have. And I promise you, it'll hold you in good stead all your life. Concentration, focus, and doing. The second most important thing I want to share with you, Akash, and your friends, is that you need to have a passion for what you want to do. You know what happens? Many times people tell me, oh, I like my work. Do you like your work? Yes, yes, of course I like my work. All right. End of the day, I'm very tired. Now, the person who likes his work is not good enough. You got to love your work. You got to feel passionate about it. You must feel that, oh, I want to do this thing completely. And the moment you do that, you don't get tired at all. If you like a girl and you after her, or a girl likes a boy, do you get tired when talking to the other person or meeting her or beating with her or the girl meeting the boy? You don't. Why? Because you're passionate about the person. So you do it. Similarly, with whatever you're doing, whatever work you're doing, whatever you're learning, learn to be passionate about it. So at the end of it, when you get into any career, it doesn't matter what the career is. It could be a light career, difficult career, acting career, whatever it is, just be passionate and disciplined about that career. The moment you do that, you cannot not be successful. One of the biggest things that have happened in life, that those people who are very successful have been passionate about it. They don't like their work. They love it. And that's how you got to remember what you got to do. The third thing, which I think is extremely important for young people to understand, is that new things are going to be difficult. But you have to remember that change is inevitable. Everything in the country will change. A COVID will bring about a change. When you grow from schools to colleges, it will be a change. When you finish your graduation, there will be a big change. All these changes are going to take place in life. And you have to learn about doing it. 35 years ago, this company called Reliance was textiles 99.9%, which meant the company actually turnover was 99% textiles. Their profit was 99% out of textiles. Today, do you know what is the percentage of textiles in Reliance? It's less than 0.1%, which is shocking, because in 20 years, 25 years, the company has completely changed. But because it has changed, because it has absorbed new ideas, because they have taken up new businesses and thoughts, which is very difficult to do. And remember, change is not easy. But once you learn how to adapt to changes that take place, whether it's a COVID change, or it is an economic change, or it is a job change, or any other thing in your life, personal life or otherwise, changes are going to take place at different stages in life. So another thing which is extremely important is to see that you're mentally ready for change and be there. What does that mean? It also means you have to learn to get out of your comfort zone. What do I mean by that? Once you get habituated to work a certain way, live a certain way, have habits in a certain way, we're not easy to make to new adaptations that take place. So you got to learn how you get out of that comfort zone that you have got into because of the old way, and you got to move into the new territories that have become extremely important. There are certain things that we have to learn. So let's say you have taken up commerce, but you're actually weak at economics, and that's one of your subjects. So what do? We kind of ignore that subject because that's not the subject I like. That's not the subject that I'm strong at, feel sleepy, or I get distracted. So it's not going to happen. So my secret has been that whenever I have something like this, I'm just determined to read a page or two of that every single day, whether I like it or I don't like it. But it's only 2 pages. 2 pages is not difficult to do. So the secret is to take one step forward every day. So whether it's reading a book, picking up a subject, learning a new thing to do, learning how to use a new phone, how many times you keep on trying on the new phone before you get used to it. But since you like to do it, it's easy to do it. So you got to do the same about various subjects that you really want to do. And that makes it very, very interesting in terms of what you want to do. And the last thing which I want to mention before we really take up questions, if you have any, is the fact that you got to be, Akash, a learner all your life. My father, Dr. Lh Hiranandani, he's no more. He died at age 96, which is about 5 years ago. At the age of 80, one morning we were having tea together. And he was a surgeon. He was a ear, nose, throat surgeon. So he told me early morning, he says, Niranjan, I want to go to Germany to learn a new operation. I thought he'd gone pots. 82, and he wants to now go to Germany to learn a new operation. And he convinced me. And he said, why not? What's wrong with 82? And he did. He went to Germany to learn a new operation. And he did. And he came back. Unfortunately, after a year or so, he got Parkinson's. So he could not really utilize the learning that he did. But he was willing to learn at any and every age. So, young friends, when you finish graduation, when you finish any other course that you do, remember one thing, you have to be a learner forever. It doesn't mean that you got to learn your subject, but there are always so many things to learn from life. You can learn from mentors, learn from so many other methodologies which are now available, or pedagogies which were not there before. So you have a great opportunity to learn. So keep learning all your life, because you not to be up to date, you have to be ahead of other people. And the more you learn and continuously learn, you will always, always be more confident because you have learned the new things. And other people become lethargic. They say, oh, I've already graduated. I've already got a job. Why do I need to learn anything? And that's something, a mistake which you should never make. At least you students should never make. You know, let other people make that mistake, so that you can overtake them anytime in your life and careers, professions or otherwise, or other businesses. So young friends, this country has a great future. Remember, we're talking about a $5 trillion economy. Yes, this year we have a setback, but I promise you, within a year or so, the GDP growth will come back and there'll be huge opportunities of growth in India. And this is a place to be. And there are lots and lots of things for young people to take up in the future. We want you to see that you can take up new subjects that are there. You should see whether it's possible to pick up, be incubators of new ideas and thoughts which can be there, be innovators, do all sorts of things which are there. But one thing you must not forget, and that is, don't forget to have a good time in college. So along with all the studies and hard work you do, which you must also have a good time. So in life, you must have a blend, a good time with good studies or great studies. Don't have to sacrifice one for the other completely, except in exam time. But otherwise, really the secret is work hard, play hard, have good fun and be happy. And that's the way to go, because this is the best time of your life. So enjoy yourself and have a wonderful time. Pick some good habits. Get the discipline in order to get your subject done. I promise you, you will have a great career and a future which will be second to none. I wish you all the best. And I'm now, Akash, open for any questions that you may have.
Thank you so much, sir. Like, this was one of the best speech, because each and every part you said was completely relatable, at least for me. I don't know about others, but at least for me. So thank you so much for that. So I'm going to come to a lot of parts on whatever you have said. But before that, I need to ask you, tell us one of your good time in your college time. That's how we can relate to you more. And then we'll ask our questions.
Oh, there were lots of fun. I used to go to Willingdon Club that time. And I played games of squash, and I did a lot of swimming, and I had a lot of friends over there. So we had lots of fun, and I enjoyed that bit of time when we used to do that part. We used to go to movies a couple of times, Punk's College also, and went over there. But fairly did well, and there were lots of good fun with groups of friends that I enjoyed over there. But at the end of the day, I stood second in the University of Bombay in BCom, So I did study also, but I enjoyed also. I had a good time with friends and made lots and lots of friends and all. And I participated in many extracurricular activities. And that helped me to now take up leadership roles without a hesitancy. So what happens is when you get into all the extracurricular activities of your college, institutions, and circle.
You used to get attendance for that?
I don't remember that, but I did bunk certain lectures and certain teachers whom I didn't like. I bunked a lot. But overall, I think it was okay.
But yes,
I don't remember getting an overall bad attendance, but may not have been very great attendance.
No problem. So you're the kind of person everyone wishes to be. But sir, you know, there's this one thing which our parents tell us all the time. Ki humlo ne tujhse zyada duniya dekhi hai. Okay. And you run 11 colleges, 8 schools, 1 skill development center, and you give lecture every week. Every week you are giving a lecture. So you aapne duniya bahut zyada dekhi hui hai. Tell us, when you go to different colleges or when you interact with different people in those colleges and school, you know, there's this one thing which you would have developed. Ki, you know, this is some kind of thing which attracted you. Ye dimag mein aa gaya. This person from this college, ye yaad aa gaya. So what are those things which you know ki bhai ye banda to aage jayega ya gare. I'm not saying in a bad way, but you know, you just know because you have apne junior zyada dekhe. That's the reason.
So it's very, very difficult to decide that a particular person is going to be successful in life or not.
Yeah.
Because what happens is that there is a difficulty called consistency. So sometimes young people burn out and they just really don't flower the way they should be. What you got to learn is be consistent in what you do or whatever you take up and be diligent about it. And the secret of that is what I said first, which is that you must love what you do. Those people who enjoy the work that they do or the study that they do or the job that they take or the apprenticeship that they take or the internship that they take and revel into all of that and enjoy that. Also, you enjoy the party part, but you should also enjoy this part of it. People look at it as a burden. Arre, ye pura ho gaya. Ye kaam abhi khatam ho gaya. Isliye abhi main maza karunga, masti karunga. You really have to be in such a way that the work that you do is also got to be fun. So for me, let me give you an example. My real estate business. It's a very boring business for so many of them. And many of the builder friends that I talk to, main 3 ghanta kaam kiya, itna concentration iske upar kiya, aur kya wo contractor ke saath baat hua, aur wo hua, wo hua. Abhi main thak gaya hu, abhi main jaake ghar chale jaunga. While I would say the other way around, I learned so much from the contractor. It was great fun. I negotiated with him. And he taught me a couple of things which the other builders are doing. So I learned that from him. And I negotiated with him and I told him this thing. And I convinced him that we need to make a good product because I want people to be happy who actually bake the flats. And I tell the contractor that I will give his name to every person who has bought a flat in my building. So he will know not only the builder, that is me, but he'll also know my contractor. So I tell him, aapko mashhoor. So what happens is, instead of that being a painful exercise with the contractor, it becomes an interesting interaction. You learn from the contractor what he does with other builders, what are the tricks other builders do to get some idea. So if you look at it from a positive angle, it's fun. From a negative angle, it's a pain. You got to negotiate. You got to do this. Wo khichega, hum khichega. And all that will go on till you get exhausted with it. But if you enjoy it, which I do, I love it, in fact, I'm always interested to talk to people, architects, engineers, contractors, suppliers. They all give me ideas to do. Even my competitors, I contact them and talk to them. You know, main suna wo bahut acha aapka project gaya, kaise kiya, kya kiya. And they're willing to share with me because they want to show off. There's nothing wrong with it. So I learned a lot from them. So if you look at your project positively, kabhi thakta nahi hai, Akash.
this was one of the best answer I'm telling you. So it's not because I'm having a podcast with you, but this was one of the, I loved it. But yes, so one of the questions the audience asked is, so were you also clueless when you were of our age? Because like a lot of people, they are graduating now. They're doing masters, but they are clueless right now. They are willing to work hard, but they don't know what to work hard in. You know, kis mein karu hard work. So they are clueless that. So were you also clueless? And if you were, then what did you do?
I was more clueless than you are.
I am enjoying it talking to a billionaire.
No, but I'll tell you, when I came from a medical family, my father was a doctor, my elder brother was a doctor, my bhabhi was a doctor. Everybody was either a professional or in service. So there was nobody who was there as an entrepreneur or in business in my whole life. During my BCom, I used to intern myself into factories. So I went into a textile unit, I went into a handloom unit, I went into a tile factory. I worked all those places. And my first business was not real estate. It was textile. So I started a small factory in Charkot, Kandivali Industrial State. I was clueless about it. But because I had interned with Gwalior Rayon, a company, a famous company, I had contacts there. So I supplied gray cloth to them. And that's how I started. Then I started a little bit of real estate. Then I was losing money in both. And then one fine day, I had to close down one. Didn't know which one to close down. I was clueless. I was totally clueless, not only in college, but also when I was in the business. Because I had to close down which one to close down, Akash? I didn't know. So what did I do? I got a letter at that time from the union saying they wanted 100% increase in wages. I was shocked. But I thought to myself, and people told me, don't worry, it was 100% mang rahe, but actually if you give them 10% increase, they'll be very happy. So why don't you sit and negotiate? In my mind, I thought, I can't decide which one to throw out. So I am clueless about it. Here is a letter from the union. Maybe that's the choice I will make. So I sold off my textile unit, paid off the debts, which I couldn't handle at that time, and got into real estate in a complete way and never looked back. So I was clueless in college. I was clueless when I got into business. I was clueless when I had problems with the businesses. But you keep on doing your best at the time which you have. If I had not done it and I had chosen textile instead of real estate, maybe I would have been a textile magnate and not a real estate guy.
Oh, yes. So this is one thing I believe what is happening right now. Okay. That is, a lot of people are getting influenced by movies and stuff. Okay. So before in 80s, 90s, they were, the most popular job was to become an astronaut because it dikhta tha TV pe. Now the most popular job is to become a YouTuber. Okay. And before there was a way. People used to become engineers and scientists. Then there was MBAs because movies mein dikhta tha, MBA kehke log, you know, corporate proper dikhta tha. Then there were movies of Steve Jobs, Facebook founder and stuff. So people, there was this drive of becoming an entrepreneur. They want to do a startup. Okay. So do you really think this is happening and the next movie, the things which are based on movies, that's what people are going to actually take and not the hard sciences? Because abhi logo ko sportsman bhi banna hai, artist bhi banna hai. No one is going to say ki ab main doctor banna raha, which we need. We need hard science people also. Everyone wants to become a content creator these days because we are getting the fame right now. So do you think this is happening?
So in every generation, there is going to be waves which are going to draw people for various reasons, because it's part of TV, because it's part of the social world, because it's the talk of the town or whatever it is. So in my good old days, the only thing they talked about was doctors and engineers. Even lawyers were not so looked on upon. But today, what has happened is that the number of types of jobs which are available and the opportunities have become much more wider. Nothing wrong with the wave, but you have to remember the waves also die out. So a lot of people have to actually, unless they are on the top of the wave, everybody doesn't become a rock star and everybody doesn't become a superstar. And nobody survives, not many of the superstars also survive for many years. There are very, very, very few superstars who continue for a decade plus. So that's the story. So there's nothing wrong in following a wave. If you see an opportunity in it and you want to ride the wave, fine. But you got to find out how to ride on top of the wave. Because when the wave comes down, you shouldn't get drowned. You should still be at least riding it. So if you know the story about Amitabh Bachchan, He went through a very bad financial period, but he rode the wave. He didn't go down. He went back into acting. Kaun Banega Crorepati? He would go on it. I've seen him on sessions where he would work on TV shows from morning 9:30 to night 8 o'clock. Continuously would be available on the show because he felt that that's what he needs to do. So you learn discipline from these people. All of them are very, very disciplined people who have survived being actors also for a long time. They look very flashy, but actually they're very, very disciplined. And you'd be surprised how hard they work in their work, which they are doing. And the type of body they need to do, the type of dancing they need to do, they got to be absolutely perfect in their job if you want to be on the top. So to answer you, Akash, of course you must ride waves. Nothing wrong with it. But can you ride on top of the wave when the wave comes crashing down? That's the point.
That's the point. Last two questions, sir. After you were in real estate, what was the major setback, one failure, which, you know, that was a low point, low breaking point of yours, one setback you had in your golden days, in like, abhi bhi golden days chal raha hai, but like one thing down?
Akash, it's unfortunate to tell you the truth that there wasn't one setback, there were 20. And there were five major setbacks when I could have died or I would have felt that I'm finished financially, I'm talking about. So there were so many occasions when that happened. And this happens to everybody who's in business for a long period of time. They go through difficulties in life. They go through setbacks in life and they will go through problems in life. And I am no exception to that story. But the point is that you just dig in your heels and continue to work very hard on them and hope that you'll be able to overcome it. It's like fighting COVID today, you know, and having comorbidity, having an age against you, and still wanting to fight the COVID situation. So you have to work hard in order to see that you are alive and you're kicking and you'll be able to overcome it so that Akash, I can still see you after the COVID story is over. So unless you don't take care of that. So it's not been one story. Like I told you, the oldest story was when I was in soup between both textiles and real estate, which is as far back 1981, I'm telling you a story. So right from that time when there was a chaos and catastrophe to so many times that have taken place and much more bigger problems. And I thought that I would get bankrupt and stuff like that also have happened to me. So these kind of setbacks are there in everybody's life. Some people have emotional setbacks. For instance, your girlfriend leaves you. That's an emotional setback.
Couldn't find anyone right till now.
You're lucky. So you don't have a setback yet. When you find one, you will have one. So don't worry. Time will catch up with you and everybody else also. So the point is very simple that all these setbacks are going to take place. If not this setback, something else. So you got to learn to cope with it, dig your heels and continue life as it is, and it will overcome. So you have to overcome that, smile and go ahead. And it'll be all right because over a period of time, you'll forget it, but you got to ride it, fight it, work on it, dig your heels and go on. And there are no exceptions. So whether it's a Mukesh Ambani or Bayani or a Tata company, or any other company or corporate person or any other film star or anything, you'll find all of them have gone through setbacks and falling things in life. Who have gone over a long period of time have trouble. So mentally, physically, financially, emotionally, there are going to be setbacks in your life. You've got to just be at it and things get all right. And no exceptions. No exceptions, and I believe no exceptions. Some people may be financially setback, somebody emotionally setback, some other people physically setback, they may have a handicap due to an accident. Anything can happen, but you got to go on and do it. And there's nothing, there's nobody in life who cannot do it. And we can all overcome. There are thousands and millions of examples of people who overcome the situation and handicap. You can too.
Yes. And my one last question, sir, I'm so sorry to disturb you, but one last question. So you are doing this because you're passionate about teaching. Your first job was teaching. But what I want to ask you is, what are you not getting in return from our side? Or if you're doing this, like, what do you actually want from me if you're doing this?
I want that all of you should become successful in life. All of you should be able to meet your setbacks and get it over with. All of you should remember that hard work pays. All of you should know that there is opportunity in India, which is not there. I started with less than 2 lakhs of rupees, and now I'm on the billionaire list. I came from a family which was professional, had no business acumen, and mentally, I don't think I was fit to be a businessman at that point of time. But I learned, I worked hard, I did that, and I am where I am. So there is no reason for the young people not to be it. But so my purpose is really, can I communicate to each one of the young people that you can do it and it is possible for you to do it? But are you committed to it? Are you disciplined enough to do it? Are you willing to overcome all your negative emotions and those factors which will drill through your life and the setbacks that I had and other good people have had? And do it, do your very best. And there are thousands of people who have come back to me and said, oh, you know, I heard your lecture. In fact, in Mitipai College, there was a course on a student, professional student, some course was there, 1 year course, which I had spoken 15 years ago, maybe 20 years ago. And I met a student who had heard my lecture, and it was in Pune. And the student came up to me, touched my feet, and after 15, 20 years, and said, sir, do you know, it was because of your enthusiasm that I took up building line in, and today I'm a famous builder in Pune. So, and it was all because of the lecture that I heard from you. Otherwise, my family wanted me to take a job. So I went and took this. And I was so happy. So that delight in terms of enthusing young people to be where they are. And I can do thousands and thousands of it. You go on the YouTube and see a lot of my lectures.
I am seeing your channel every day. There's one new video. You are more famous than an influencer.
No. But really, but I love to do it, Akash. That's the only difference. So I'm not an influencer, but I love to do it. And I love people. And I love the young people because I do believe that's the future, which is really going to make a difference for our country. And if I can make a difference to one person at a time, at any point of time, it is enough for my life.
Yes, sir. We love you more. This was an amazing session. How did you feel? That's it. How did you feel, Numéro? How was it?
It was fun, Akash. I love it.
This is one of the best talks I have ever had because it was actually motivating and connecting. That's the connecting word is more important than anything else. So we wish you all the luck and thank you so much for joining. Yes.
Thank you.